Spotlight on every Tuesday at 9 p.m., re-airs Wednesdays at noon. So please watch. So that being said, I got to give you information too. I always run off the mouth before I start forgetting this. If you'd like to be a guest on my show, or you have an upcoming event, please give us at least 2 weeks' notice so we can get the studio together, and I can get a crew to come out to do filming. You can reach me at 203-417-7929 or 203-748-5456. You also can reach me at rbrought@snetnet or rbrought@gmail.com. You can look me up at facebook.com, where I have all my information. I have also the pictures I've taken with everywhere, from the Whalers to the Connecticut Cruise News, which new Connecticut Cruise News is out, and that's the Springfield bike issue. So that has a lot of information on it, on upcoming events, so please go to that and look that up. You can find that at Levine's or at Danbury Harley and many other motor places. You can also find it at Sycamore and Bethel. So, you know, please look for that. So with that being said, let's get into these the best of 2011's fights, brawls, and altercations of the Danbury Whalers versus the other teams in the Federal Hockey League. So let's watch.
You gotta throw him out! You gotta throw him out! actually, correct me on that one, Marco. On the next whistle, I accidentally, it's my first error of the night as Arnott gets it out of the zone. We have a fight going on. It looks like it's going to be Carpenter and Fulton, and Fulton putting Carpenter into the bench. Carpenter, no chance at all, and now some more rough stuff as joining the fight is number 17 for the Danville Dashers, Ferguson. He's going to be a third man in. He better watch out he doesn't get thrown out and get ejected.
But watch out he doesn't get suspended or thrown out of the league.
And now another guy's really getting in. O'Malley's in. Here we go. The bench are clearing. And all over the fight, too, is number four, Ryan Sturm. Danville is having a tough time with the Whalers. And now both benches are clearing. A big fight. Chernova's in there. Everybody's in there. We have a brouhaha in the Danville bench. This is absolutely ridiculous. This is worse than a fight last night at Cape Cod. And everybody, this is going to be a tough time sorting all these penalties. I really feel bad for the off-ice officials with this one. We have an injured player for the Dashers. He's number seven, Tyler Forbes. He must have gotten hit hard. Look at this. They're still going at it. Maloro is
watching it, and his crew cannot keep it up as right now it looks like Maloro's in, and now Temple's going in. Crazy
Bolton is trying to get back in. Deshane's is trying to hold him away. Nick Deshane's, the captain of the Whalers, holding Corey Fulton back.
And now
we have a brouhaha at the Coliseum de Androscoggin.
And the craziest part about it, Nick Nieder's standing around right now like he's waiting for his oil to be changed, and he's picking up six. That'd be the one guy I would say if there's a fight. And now he's going in.
Another one. Now the goalies want to go at it.
Now the goalies don't want to go at it. Now, we'll just went out to Lindoff.
30, 29, this 28.
This is not what you expect.
No, not at all. They got to get some order down there. And the one thing you don't want to do if you're fighting the Danbury Whalers, don't fight Nick Nieder or Peter Gretzky. They are wild dogs.
Especially Nieder. He was actually talking up on the bus about how it's been a while since he's been suspended. He shouldn't get anything for this. And right now, Chinova just staring down the bench like, come on, let's go. Fulton getting into it. Fulton bloodied and bruised.
I can only imagine how many
done.
I can only imagine how many people will be left on these benches after all the people are ejected. That's the first time I've seen that this year or any year in the FHL. This is
an absolute Donnybrook broke out.
Oh my goodness.
Sometimes it's fun.
You know what the funny part is? I'm actually coming up here. I'm with Cape Cod now. We brought our Point Street guy, Brian Baker. He's in charge.
Here we go!
Yeah.
Thank you. Corey Bolton and Warriors penalty number 27, Travis Stacy, 5 minutes each for biting at 15:44. Bolton and Stacy.